Welcome to Shaped by Faith, a special series led by health and fitness expert Teresa Rowe. Get ready for an entertaining and spirit-led adventure while learning ways you can become fit in your body, mind, and spirit. Now here's Teresa.
Hi, I'm Teresa Rowe, and welcome to Shaped by Faith, where we shape our bodies and hearts for God's purposes. I hope you enjoy this total body challenge workout that I put together in my home just for you. These exercises will help strengthen you, bring you energy, flexibility, help you with endurance, while also improving bone density, cholesterol levels, and blood pressure. Each exercise has a prayerfully chosen scripture to help strengthen our spiritual foundation. You will only need a medium to light set of weights. Let's get started. Let's go ahead and let's warm up the body. Just start moving side to side, breathing, strengthening those legs and arms. Let's just move the arms a little bit with some dynamic stretches. And breathe from your diaphragm. Keep those legs strong. And let's just march in place a little bit. And let us run with endurance the race God has set before us. And we do this by keeping our eyes on Jesus, the champion who initiates and perfects our faith. Let's do some basic squats. Just lower down in your squat and lift back up. Let's use our arms now. Reach down and reach up. And you can go a little bit wider in your squat. Today, take everything at your level and at your pace, okay? If you need to stop and take a break, then you do that. Work on that deep breathing. Work on engaging your muscles one more time. The first exercise, you just need one weight. So let's take one weight and hold it. We're going back to that squat. So let's go into a basic squat and then rotate to one side, reach it up there and bring it back. Let's do that and rotate to the other side. Now to modify, you can reach below your shoulders and just bring that weight out, or progression, bring it up. He gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless, right? He gives power to the weak. Where we are weak, God is so strong. Keep breathing, moving through this. We're also going to be working on that core today. So we will be doing some planks. I need you just to do what you can do wherever you're at today. All right, shoulder work right here, lower body and core work. Nice rotation, working the obliques, the lift, working the shoulders, and that squat, working the legs. Last one, put your weight down. Go ahead, position yourself down. Bring your hands under your shoulders. Step one leg back and the other leg back. Or you can come down on the knees and modify this. Be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. Be strong. Now to progress this, just come up on the feet and just hold this. Take a deep inhale and exhale. You can also go down to the forearm position if you want it to do that. If you need a break, just come down on the knees. Breathe. God is strengthening us and He is watching over us. I can feel this in my arms, my abdominals, in my legs. Heart rate seems like it's increasing a little bit in the plank. So we want to strengthen this body with the plank. Keep that belly pulled in to protect the back, and let's come out of it. Carefully, let's go ahead and stand up. Take your weights in your hands and bring them at your side. Now this is a side squat. You're gonna step out side to side, all right? Or you can do a basic squat. You don't have to step out. God is our refuge and He is our strength. And He's always ready to help in times of trouble. God is our refuge and our place of strength. Now feel this in your legs, and to protect the knees, I need you to sit back in your hips. So whenever you're going down into a squat position, engage those leg muscles and sit back. And I also lean back just a little bit in the heels, just side to side, and you're breathing and engaging. You're focused on the strength of the Lord. He is with us, right? A few more, just one more of these. We're going back down to the floor. So if you'd rather stay up and do a side-to-side lean, that's fine. But what we're gonna do is place one hand on the mat. One leg out, bring this arm over the head. We're just going to simply bring that knee in and out as you bring your arms over the head, reaching towards that leg. The weapons of our warfare are not of the flesh. They have divine power to destroy strongholds. So we ask God to help us destroy those strongholds, right? You have the power of Jesus Christ in you if you believe in Jesus, right? So you've got that power to say, Satan, leave in the name of Jesus Christ. Get out of here. A few more of these. All right, your heart rate is increasing on this one. We're working the obliques, the legs, and that arm. One more of these. Good job. Let's go to the opposite side. Again, place the hand down and kneel. Bring this leg out, arm way up over the head. Bring that knee in and out. Good. You just go at your pace. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And every day, and we've been talking about this a lot in these exercise shows, Lord, renew our mindset. Help us to think the thoughts that you have for us. Keep going. You're doing a good job working the obliques and the legs, hips, arms. I know you're doing good. Keep going with me. So glad you're here with me to exercise. Keep going, breathing. And God has given us love to share with others. And think about someone today that you can encourage. All right, there's always someone that you can encourage. One more. This next exercise is called a reverse plank. So go ahead and sit down. Bring your hands back behind you. Now, I just want you to try it, okay? Fingers towards you and lift the hips off the floor. Hold, just do what you can do. Just hold right there. Look towards your legs. Keep your belly in. I'm feeling this in the triceps. All right, we can do this. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us, right? Good job. You did great. Let's go ahead and place the legs in a really wide squat position to strengthen those legs. Bring your arms down in front of you with your palms facing you. And we're just going to work on the right arm in this section right here. So lower down, bring that right arm up. Let's just work on that one arm. Good. And if you want to, you can bring it below the shoulder, that elbow, or bring it way up high. The spirit who lives in you is greater than the spirit who lives in the world. God is greater. He is the spirit that's living in you than he that's living in the world, right? So let's remind ourselves of that. God, you are so great. You are so amazing, so wonderful. Let's praise him today. Let's thank him today for everything, right? We got out of bed. I had my coffee. I got to scoop my belly. I'm getting to exercise with you. It's a great day. Let's start on that opposite arm. So both arms down again, plie or squat wide, and bring that opposite arm up. And just really focus on keeping the arm engaged, keeping those muscles strong, keeping the navel to the spine. The Lord is my strength and shield. The Lord is my strength. I trust him with all of my heart. God, I trust you. Just say that. Just say that. God, I trust you. I trust you with my heart. I trust you with my life, my destiny, the story you wrote all about me, Father. I trust you. I trust you with my family. Lord, you can see what's going on here, right? I trust you to work out all things for the good of us and for your glory. Let's keep going. Doing fantastic. Bring that arm up a few more times. I love this exercise to strengthen the arms. And last one. Now on this next segment, what we're gonna do is a front lunge, step front, bring it back. Now I want you to go out diagonal. All right, let's do that again. Front lunge and bring it back. As long as your knees don't bother you. Like if your knees bother you, just keep the lunge to the front, okay? And then bring it out diagonal. Now we're gonna add some biceps to this. Add those arms, diagonal lunge. The Lord is faithful. He will strengthen you and he will guard you. God is so faithful. So don't worry about things. God's working things out for your good and for His glory. You stay faithful to Him, keep your eyes focused on Him, and He'll work everything out. He always does. As you look back on your life, you can see that. So if He helped back then, He's going to help now. Last one. All right, now opposite leg, front lunge, bring it back. Diagonal lunge, and then back again. Let's do that. Front lunge, bring it back, and diagonal lunge. Let's add some biceps. Hammer curls right there. You're doing good. The character of God is a tower of strength, isn't it? The character of God is a tower of strength. I love that one. God, your character is a tower of strength. Lord, I run to you every single day. Keep moving. We're strengthening these legs and these biceps and the core with this balance challenge. And so you have to deep breathe from the diaphragm. Remind yourself to breathe, keeping the mouth open. Let's do that a few more times to the front. Last time, diagonal. We're going back out into the plank. So if you would rather stand up and do side-to-side leans or a chop, that's perfectly fine. But if you want to join me in a plank, let's do it together. Hands under the shoulders, and then bring the knees back, and then lower. Now, keep the bottom down, and you should feel this in the core. So I'm doing a modified plank position. You're going to hold this to progress. Come up on those toes and hold it right there. Now we're going to breathe and we're going to hold this plank a little bit longer. So if you need to come out of it and stretch, that's fine. Be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. Lord, the only way that I can be strong is through you. You're the one that gives me strength when I don't have it. And Father, you know I don't have it most days of the week, but you do. Lord, you've got it all planned out. If I would trust in you and look to you for my strength, emotional strength, physical strength, all those things, Father, that I need, and that peace in my heart that only you can grant me. Father, I'm so thankful that you saved me, that you reached down and you pulled me out of the pit of despair, and you set me on your solid foundation. God, I'm so thankful. Lord, your grace is so sufficient. Just breathe. How you doing? We're almost there. You're doing fantastic, by the way. All right, keep holding it. Inhaling and exhaling. Planks are hard and they're challenging, but if you start practicing them, like 5 seconds here, then 10 seconds, and then 15 seconds, you'll do just fine. All right, let's carefully come on up. On this next set, what we're going to use is one weight. So we're going to bring the legs out wide again. We're going to take the one weight, bring it up behind us, and do a basic tricep extension with a really wide squat. So you can call this sumo squat or a plie. I press on to reach the end of the race and receive the heavenly prize for which God, through Christ Jesus, is calling us, right? We're all in this race together, eyes on Jesus. We're a team, right? We're a body of believers. We can do this together, right? We can. So let's encourage one another, come alongside one another, and let's get this race going. A few more. One more. You did great. Go ahead and grab one weight and go out wide. We're going to a figure eight, and so we're going to bring one weight back behind us, bring it out in front, and bring it behind that knee and back out in front. So you can definitely modify this and just stand up, and you don't have to bring it behind that knee. You could do some side-to-side leans or reach down. You will keep in perfect peace all who trust in you, all whose thoughts are fixed on you. See, that's the key. All whose thoughts are fixed on you. There it is right there. God, He gives us so much wisdom in His Word, and He unfolds it before us. And just let those words highlight your heart today. He will give us peace as our eyes are fixed on Him. Feeling this in the legs for sure, and through the arms, that core is engaged. Just taking that weight behind the knee, out in front, and one more. Nice work. This next one, we're gonna use this weight sort of like a kettlebell. So what we're gonna do is swing it through the legs, bring it up, and then extend over the head. Let's do that again. So you're swinging the arms in this one. You're inhaling as you lower. Exhale as you come up. Search for the Lord and His strength and continually seek Him. So keeping our eyes again focused on Christ, and His strength is right there for us. So the main thing is keep our eyes focused on Christ, right? In everything that we do. Inhale lower, exhale up, good. So you should be feeling this in your triceps and definitely hips and legs. Let's do that one more time. All right, place this weight down. We're going back down to the floor for that kneeling abdominal exercise. Bring the leg out. Start to bring that knee in and out. Just simply in and out. Exhaling as the knee comes towards you. Inhaling as it goes out. Keep focusing our eyes on Jesus. He's the author and perfecter of our faith. So today we're really focused in on scriptures that point just directly to Jesus. Focus in on Him. All right, feeling this in the obliques. That's the muscles that make up the waistline. Help support us right in the center of that body. Moving that leg, moving that arm. Keeping the mouth open to breathe. Keep going, we're almost there. Doing a fantastic job. One more of these. Let's repeat that on the opposite side. So again, place the hand under the shoulder, bring the opposite leg out, arm over the head, and just start. Don't be afraid, don't be discouraged. For the Lord will personally go ahead of you. You know, I think about that a lot of times when I have to meet with someone, or maybe I've been in an interview before, and I pray and I say, Lord, I need your help here. And I know He's already been in there. He's already sent His angels ahead of me, so I don't need to worry about it, right? You don't need to worry about it either. But pray, pray about it. All right, keep breathing here. You're doing fantastic. Bringing the knee in, and that elbow towards the knee, working the obliques, the legs and the hips. Let's do this two more times. One more, good job. Go ahead and position yourself back in that plank position. Bring the knees back, the hands directly under the shoulders, the belly in, just hold right here. Hold right here, breathe deep, inhale, exhale. If you want to, go ahead and come all the way up and hold that. Run to win. Run to win, right? All athletes are disciplined in their training. So I'm talking about, you know, that spiritual training, that life lessons, that, you know, information and wisdom that we get from the Word of God. And also, physical training's good. The Word says a little bit of physical training is good, but we really need to train our spirits more than we train our bodies. And when we can combine them both, that's just bonus, right? Oh, it feels so good to combine them both. Just hold here and breathe. Doing great. All right, we're gonna go down to the knees. Let's go back in that shell stretch a little bit because we're gonna go back to a plank, but this time go into a forearm plank. So position yourself all the way down on the forearms. Come up on the knees just a little bit and hold. Just hold right here. You know, sometimes we just need to be still in the presence of the Lord. If you want to progress this, come up on the toes and hold. Just be still in the presence of the Lord. Just breathe before Him. And then sometimes I just need to keep my mouth closed and not say a word and just listen. So I'm reading the Word, just allowing God to speak to my heart through His Word, His inspiration, His encouragement. Keep holding. You're doing great. Just a few more seconds here. Now we're going to go ahead and lower down through the knees. Go all the way back. This is called a shell stretch, right? Right here. God is always the strength of my heart, and He remains the strength of my heart. And Lord, we love You. We honor You. We posture our hearts before You. And we ask, Father, that You would have Your way with us. Your will be done in our lives on earth as it is in heaven. Right? To God be the glory and the honor and the praise forever and ever and ever. Amen. We're going to practice that reverse plank again. So go ahead and place your hands back behind you with your fingers facing you. Extend your legs out there, and you can bend your knees as well. And try your best and just lift off that floor. If you want to hold just for a few seconds, that's fine. You can always lower back down. I will guide you along the best pathway for your life. You know, God always does. He's got the best route. You know, sometimes I've tried to take a few shortcuts and they just didn't work out too well. So I've learned to trust God and go by what He's speaking to my heart and not that shortcut that I want to take to try and make things easier. I mean, we've all been there and done that before. Now hold this, you're feeling this in your arms and your core and your legs, and let's lower back down. Let's go into a forearm side plank. So bring your forearm on the floor with your elbow lined up under your shoulders. Bring both legs out there. Remember the modification, you can bend the knees and come up through the hips. But to progress, stack those legs out there, come on up, and you can always leave your arm right there, or you can bring it up and hold. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding, right? We're talking about trusting God. We're talking about keeping our eyes focused on God. We're talking about direction. God's got the master blueprint, so why wouldn't we go to Him for direction, right? All right, so this forearm plank, you should definitely feel this in your legs, in your core, in your abdominals, in your arms. Notice your breathing, nice deep breaths, and let's lower down. Let's repeat that on the opposite side. So bringing that opposite forearm down, extending the legs out or bend the knees, and go up into a modified position. Lift the hips off the floor, bring the arm up if you want, or remember you can bring it directly at your side and just hold. I tell you the truth, anyone who believes has eternal life. Anyone who believes has eternal life, right? Do you believe in Jesus? Do you want to turn your life over to Him today? I'm telling you, you will experience a love that you have never experienced before when Jesus comes into your heart. But you have to ask Him. Say, Father, I need You in my life. I need You, Father. And confess your sins. Don't be obsessed with them, but just confess them. And then just say, Lord, take me over. I need You. And just believe and trust Him. Let's lower down. Now we're going to go ahead and transition to the floor all the way down. We're going to find that neutral spine position where the low back is down. Bring the legs up in a tabletop position and place the hands back behind you. Now you're just going to go ahead and kind of crunch up just a little bit right there and lower down. To modify this, just place your feet on the mat and then come up and down. I will advise you, the Lord says, and I will watch over you. Again, you can leave the legs up in the tabletop position. Just come up where you feel that in your core and lower back down. God is going to advise you. Let Him be your advisor, right? Go to Him with your questions and your concerns and also your real good days. Praise Him for those days. Thank Him in all circumstances, right? One more. Now we're going into the crisscross. Bring one knee in towards you and then rotate towards it and then keep alternating those legs. All scripture, every single bit of scripture is inspired by God, right? And it's useful for teaching us, for encouraging us, for inspiring us. Keep moving through the crisscross, inhaling and exhaling, keeping that belly pulled in. You can do this. I'm so glad you're exercising with me today. I really am. I feel that even though you're on the other side of that screen, that our spirits can connect with one another, the Spirit of Christ. Keep it going, keep moving, inhaling and exhaling. Nice, bring those legs in. Back stretch, just kind of rock side to side or just hold it here or modify one foot down and hold. Just breathe and stretch. Switch out opposite leg and hold. We're gonna press on, right? Towards the goal for the prize with the upward calling of God in Christ Jesus. And again, switch out those knees. Exhale right there. Hold it, breathe and stretch. Let's do that again. Keep the belly in. All right, now we're gonna come all the way up to a seated position. Bring the legs out in front of you. Let's do a few side lanes. Bring the arms up and over. Hold right there and stretch and switch out and hold. That feels so good, those side lanes. Feels great to the obliques and the body, the upper body. A few more each direction. I hope you've been inspired and encouraged today. God's word always encourages me. Thank you for allowing me in your home today. I hope you're motivated to continue preparing yourself to be the best you can be. As we continue exercising and praising God together, He will bless our bodies and hearts for His purposes. It is God who made us and breathed His Spirit in us so we can encourage others to live for Him. Until next time, may the Lord bless you, keep you safe, healthy, and strong in your body, mind, and spirit.
Tune in next time as we continue shaping bodies and hearts for God's purposes with Teresa Rowe as we all become shaped by faith.